to coach such a great group of guys. I kept telling myself, you know, I'm happy for my wife, you know, being there for so long. But I kept telling myself that, you know, once the final buzzer sound, I was beyond myself, where it wasn't personal for me to be so happy. I was just so happy for these guys sitting right here and the rest of the guys with all the hard work, the fussing, you know, just the verbal fights and practice, trying to, you know, weather the storm. And just to see those guys victorious when the final buzzer sound, I'm just overwhelmed.
Questions?
Coach, the girls had lost beforehand. Did you guys feel a little bit more of a, I don't want to say pressure, but a need to say we got to bring home a state title to?
Yes. It was very important for us. You know, they're young girls, but it was very important for us to line up on both sides and to cheer them on for a good game. So, and they was behind us, but we made that emphasis to say, ladies, job well done. So we just going to go out there. Knew we was playing a good team, and we just said, got to bring one home. Somebody from the league got to bring one home.
Tae'Quan, you missed a couple of free throws, but maybe about five or six in a row there in the second overtime. How did you kind of calm down in a game that was getting wild there at the end and make those and concentrate?
My coach said, don't worry, just hit the next one. And I was struggling during the game, and he just told me to hit the free throws and we'll win it.
What's he meant to this team, Coach Tae'Quan, this year?
Tae'Quan is the guy that actually, he's very important in a situation when teams come out of the zone and they go man-to-man. They pretty much put their big on Tae'Quan, and we really tell him to go, but tonight he was kind of second-guessing himself, you know, and he accepted it, but, you know, so we had to sub him out and, you know, get somebody else out there that was a little more confident, but, you know, he's just so major to the program where he can do it all, and he sacrificed his game from scoring points.
Another player stepped up was Blackwell, hitting those key three-pointers. Just talk about his play today.
You know, I'm excited for, you know, Dae'Vaughn. You know, watching him come up from JV, you know, you got the guys that score night in and night out. And when we needed him, I mean, he's overconfident, you know, the whole season, shooting threes. He just didn't shoot a lot. But he was ready to go. I saw it in his eyes, and the whole bench just kept telling him, Dae'Vaughn, be ready, you know, take the shot. And I thought he hit some real, real big shots to keep us in the game and to pretty much put a cushion on us to close out.
Did you ever dream of hitting 5 threes in the state championship game tomorrow?
Of course.
What was different tonight? Did you do that? I mean, how did you get it done?
Coach always just told me to stay locked and loaded, keep my feet set, just hit it.
Joe, how does it feel kind of come full circle, which, you know, about to graduate, you know, as a sophomore, you guys played in the state championship. Just take me back. How does that feel for you?
It's a great feeling to bring one back to the city. 10th grade year, it was a very, very heartbroken situation, but we just kept it in the back of our mind as motivation, and we just used it to win.
So you think if you guys wouldn't have suffered that loss last season, you know, coming into this year with that motivation, you think you would have made it back at this point?
Yeah, of course. Our coach always told us, he was like, 10th grade year, we can be back. And 11th grade year, definitely sort of set it back. But this year, we just kept being focused, kept just playing hard, and we got it done.
Dereon, it seemed like when Joe and Jalen fouled out, your offense hit another level. Talk about those back-to-back buckets you hit to give your team a bit of a cushion.
I just seen that it was a close game, and when those two guys fouled out, so I knew I was like the next option, looking at Tae'Quan, and they might hit the three, so I just had to do whatever I had to do to get my team a W.
And talk about that. You get a state title. I mean, it was close, but you're going out with a state title. What does that mean to you?
It's just a good feeling, because I just didn't want to have that feeling we had 2 years ago at the state championship.
Coach Brown, earlier this week we talked about how much Dereon has matured in the years since he came over to Lake Teller. Just talk about how big he was for you guys this year.
I thought he was very integral, and not even the scoring. I think probably 20 or so, and double figure rebounds. But he's the epitome of a team player. You know, I thought his play was exceptional. You know, when you got guys like that of his caliber, that's an MVP on the team. A lot of teams have MVPs when they're standoffish. You know, they're pretty much their own thing. You know, I watched DB throughout the whole season laughing, you know, wrestling with the younger guys. And I don't think, you know, his status where he was, it didn't affect him. He just was a team player that did whatever it took to get us wins. And major asset to the program, man. I'm very happy for him.
Dereon, if you could take us through the sequence of the end of regulation, like just the three-pointer, like who was it that, you know, dove on the floor to get the ball and then pass it to you, and then, you know, describe, you know, what it's like to shoot those free throws at 4 times a second?
Well, like I said, like, I just didn't want to be like our previous teammate 2 years ago in the state championship when he had the game on the line and free throws, he missed both. I tried to make both of them, but one of them slipped, so I just knew I had to make the second one and take it over time.
And do you know who was it in that scramble that got you the ball there?
Okay.
Keshawn
Ward. We put him in, and that was only the second time subbing in, you know. But he was locked in on the game, and if we don't get that rebound, the game is over. So that might be the biggest play with limited time on the court in Lake Teller boys basketball history, that play right there. You know, not Dereon, who scored a lot of points, not Joe Bryant. You know, I'm going to remember Keshawn Ward, one of the smaller guys in there getting the offensive rebound, giving us an opportunity to win a state title. That's what it's all about.
Coach Bryant, how much pressure was on you, you know, to accomplish this year? You guys were, you know, favored, and you had the, you know, the senior class coming back. But how much pressure was on you to, you know, do exactly what you just did?
I don't think it was a lot of pressure on us because we set a rough schedule, you know, get some pretty good teams to prepare for this. So I don't think it was pressure. And I'll say this. If it has anything to do with the win tonight, you know, I'm a God-fearing man with a lot of faith, and I prayed 2 years ago to win to silence my critics. You know, this year I just prayed to God to keep us healthy and keep us in a mindset that give us an opportunity to win. So it was no pressure on me. I released the critics. And that was the pressure that was on me the last 2 years because I wanted to silence them. So this year was no pressure. It was just straightforward, stay focused. Our biggest thing was this year was tunnel vision. And what I mean by that is the whole program has to have tunnel vision. Don't look to the left, don't look to the right, but look to the light at the end of the tunnel. And I think that's what we did.
You guys good?